Consent, Simpson. Don't open the door.
Jax, there is a fire in this hotel. We have to get out of here.
I know,
but we're not going anywhere.
Mom, did you see the firefighter got lost?
It's okay, buddy. Come on. No, come on. It's all right. Okay, put your arms around me. All right. Okay? So hold on. Just hold on.
You look awful.
Thanks. We don't have time for sweet talk.
Look, you know, she's right. You took in a lot of smoke. You should rest before you pass out again.
Oh, I got a better idea.
To know the truth until right this very minute. Carly, I'm so sorry. Sonny is Christina's father. You lying bitch.
Treasure ever seemed important.
Yeah. Trade every penny of that $25 million to get you out of here safe.
We'll both be safe. As soon as the helicopters can land, no one else is gonna die.
Thinking about Xander?
I can't believe he's gone.
I'm sorry.
Nicholas. You had no way of knowing about that fire, okay? You can't blame yourself.
Lucky, this is unacceptable. These people need to be evacuated. Now, you get on that damn radio of yours and you do something about it.
There are people in more danger than we are.
You stop badgering, Daddy. We need to pull together as a family. Oh, I forgot. That doesn't include you.
No, it doesn't.
May I have a moment alone with my grandson, please?
We've already done this?
Yeah, it's okay. I want to check on Grandfather. He's taking this so hard. Okay.
Nicholas, it's foolish to wait for the helicopter. You need to try the stairs.
The explosion blew out the 10th floor stairwell.
Nicholas, you heard what Lucky said. Strong and resourceful. Now, if the 10th floor is impassable, you can come back up, but you must try. If you wait here, you may not survive.
All right, just hold on to me. Don't look at the fire. Come on. Hope you're all okay. Okay, here we go. Here we go. You okay? Come on. Can you take? Yeah, okay, here. Okay. You got it? Yeah. Come on. Let's go. Come on. Oh. Oh, mine. We need to get out of here. Come on. Okay. Yes. Damn it. This isn't working.
Take Skippy first.
No, I'm gonna tie him to the landing, okay? I'm just gonna tie him to the landing. As soon as I get you to safety, I will come back and get him.
Please, I can't leave Skippy.
I promise. come back and get him.
Skippy, I love you.
All right, we need to go. Come on. We gotta go. Hold on to me.
I can't move.
Yes, no. Hold on to me. Let's go. Give me your hand.
Come on.
Come on, watch your hands. Watch your hands. Hold on to me. I know. Hold on to me. Hold on to me. You're okay. You're okay.
It's okay. Come on. Come here, guys. Yeah. Listen to me. We need to keep moving.
I want my mom and dad.
We'll find them, Molly. We'll get you guys to them as soon as we can.
It's only going to be a little further. We had 6 more floors, okay? Come on. Come on. Okay.
Cover your mouth.
What's wrong with the stairs?
They might be blocked on the lower floors.
Well, and you know that because of your vast experience as a bar owner?
You want to go down there, you go ahead. I don't know what you're going to find. I'm going this way.
Look, I like you, Luke, but not enough to die. I'm going.
What about you? You trust my instincts?
You wouldn't leave me in that conference room. I'm not about to leave you now. Besides, I always think it's a good idea to do the opposite of whatever Faith does.
Suit yourselves. I'm ready. Let's make a run for it. I've got a white towel put over my face, and
no,
I just kind of feel like it's now or never, you know?
I think we should stay here.
Stay and wait to be rescued? The fire is only going to get worse. What if nobody comes?
Do you smell smoke?
No.
Exactly. That's because we're on the upper floor. We're in an isolated corner, and the penthouse, it has its own ventilation system, okay? And there's reinforced doors. So this is probably the safest spot in the building.
Well, wait.
Good. Good choice.
Thank you for saving me.
You're welcome.
Chuck, you didn't happen to see anything else in the hallway, did you?
You mean like the laundry cart, which was, I'm assuming, full of treasure? You're even dreaming about going
after
that.
No, I'm not. No. God, no. I'm enjoying breathing, and that's how it's going to stay.
Good.
I really don't know why you bothered to rescue me.
Sam!
Hey.
Looks like your little cupcake is gone.
What are you doing here?
Following you. I have a proposition I think you'll find intriguing.
We are trapped in this elevator, and we are probably gonna die here, and you are using the last few minutes to hurt me with your vicious lies about Sonny being Christina's father? What the hell?
Carly, please, please. Oh, please don't move unless you want the last cable to break.
Okay, well, I knew you were better, but this is pathetic.
I wanted to tell you the truth. I saw the DNA test.
Ned is Christina's father.
Ned changed the DNA test because he was afraid of what would happen to Christina. So was I. I was afraid because people die around Sonny. My sister died because of Sonny, and I didn't want anything to happen to my daughter.
No, you just...
I was afraid that he would take her from
no,
me.
No, you weren't. You were just thought it was easier to lie through your damn teeth.
How can you judge me when he's doing everything in his power right now to take your children away from you just because he's angry? How can you sit there and say that you don't know how I feel?
Okay, Alexis. While you're dumping this confessional on me, why don't you just be honest with yourself for a minute? You didn't want to share Christina with anyone, and that is why you jumped through hoops to get rid of Ned as soon as he helped you lie to Sonny.
I wanted to protect my daughter from a violent man. And now, he may be the only parent that she has, and neither of them are gonna know. Oh, my God. Oh, my God. What have I done? What have I done?
primetime sizzles with today's episodes of General Hospital tonight. The fire brings the unexpected. A hero emerges.
And I'm giving you a gift.
$10 million.
A secret becomes a weapon.
Did you tell Sonny that he was Christina's father?
And lives are at stake. It's not over when the smoke clears. It's just the beginning.
Nicholas, call out to me!
Watch an all-new General Hospital, weeknights at 10, in primetime, only on SoapNet.
Hey, I'm his daughter. The doctor said I could sit with him. How's he doing?
Your father's in serious but stable condition. The doctor is hopeful that he'll regain consciousness soon.
Thanks. Dad. It's me, Maxie. I'm so sorry. I know you went to that basement looking for Xander. I'm the one who hid him there. If I would have told you where he was, none of this would have ever happened. You wouldn't be hurt. Xander would still be alive. I'm so sorry. I did this all wrong. And I love you so much. Please don't die on me, Tim.
Hey, take it easy, your husband, all right? You're gonna be okay.
Elena thinks I should try and get down the stairwell.
What do you think?
I think it's worth a try. I mean, it doesn't look like the helicopter's going to be making rescues anytime soon.
Yeah, people are starting to realize it, too.
I know. They're getting scared. Look, if there's an accessible route down the stairs, then we can evacuate.
All right, well, let's try. It's better than sitting here waiting.
Sit down and rest, Daddy. Others do the worrying.
Spare me the phony concern.
Geez, Daddy, we're trapped in a burning building. We may not make it out alive. What possible reason would I have to be phony? I love you. Why do you let everybody in but me?
Because you frighten me, Tracy. You always have. When I look at you, I see the worst of myself.
Well, I've succeeded. All I ever wanted was to be just like you.
Wait here, okay? Hang on. Wait there.
Keep her back.
No. We can't. We gotta stay ahead of the fire.
I don't know if we get the kids in this debris.
Beck, we have to. It's the only way we're gonna get them to safety.
We'll both get out of this. Surviving is what we do best, Sonny.
What's your point?
Well, it's been a tough year, hasn't it? Business has suffered while you've been preoccupied with your personal situation. And now that you've gotten your distractions out of the way, you're ready to get back to business. And you can use a partner to help you rebuild.
You know, you're wasting time. We have not got. I don't trust you. I never will. What's your point here?
Yeah, I can see why Carly left you for Alcazar. He's got more vision. Probably more guts, too.
Take your deal with him, then.
Carly was a guest at this hotel? That means that she and her lover could be crispy critters real soon. Is that what you were counting on? Or, maybe deep down inside, you're still worrying about little Carly.
Do you understand we could die? You're wasting time.
I don't know if it's ironic symmetry or just a cosmic joke that I should be spending what could be the last moments of my life with you. Would you just quit yapping? I don't think confronting my mortality should be considered yapping. Fine. You sit and confront your mortality. But my boys are not growing up without their mother.
Oh, God, Carly. You're trying to get us killed.
Yeah, as opposed to what?
Sitting here and waiting to die? You know what? I am not going to wait until that last cable snaps and we fall. You know, it might be your idea of a workable solution, but it's certainly not mine. What do you see?
It seems like we dropped some floors, so I'm wondering if we can pry open the doors. We'll be at a floor instead of a cement wall. Please, don't jump anymore. If that last cable breaks, we're gonna die. Get up off your butt and help me pry open these doors.
We need help here!
How can I thank you?
It's all right, it's all right.
You wanted to find your husband and you stopped to help a perfect stranger. You're an angel of mercy. You really, really are.
I'm gonna go back and I'm gonna get your dog.
Be careful.
I will. Could you do me a favor?
Yes, anything.
Okay, my husband's name is Jason Morgan. Okay, if he's been evacuated, will you tell him that Courtney is looking for him and that she loves him?
Yes.
Any moment. Get Molly.
Come on.
All right, buddy.
Hang on, right there, okay?
Fly high. Coming in for a landing.
Okay, there you go.
Right there, hang on.
Keep moving.
I'm down here. It's your turn. Come on. Oh, boy. Come on, Alexis. You've always thought you're better than me. Now's your chance to prove it. I was better than you. Just smarter and classier. You're clearly a better athlete. And you have much better survival instincts. Okay. Kind of like a cockroach. Okay, would you just stop talking? Do this.
Don't
come on.
Treat me.
What if I fall? You just do this. Do it for Christina. Come on. Okay, I guess you're gonna live. Kind of makes you rethink that whole spilling your guts thing, huh? You can't tell Sonny. He'll take it from me. Don't worry about that yet. We are a long way from getting out of here alive.
This is what I'm looking for.
What? Is this the security room?
Yeah, with monitors showing what's going on all over the hotel. See there? That's the north stairwell where Faith is. Looks like it's blocked at the 10th floor. She's gonna run into a dead end. Here. The west stairwell is open.
Well, let's take the west stairwell.
Look. Check this out. Look here.
Well,
A laundry cart?
Yeah. Now, who would leave that in the middle of a hallway during a fire?
I know how you must have felt when you saw me with Sonny.
I don't think you do.
Why don't you just leave me in the hallway?
I don't hate you, Sam. I just hate your choices. I'm gonna get us some dinner, okay?
Great. I'm starving. Jax. When do you think we're gonna get rescued?
It shouldn't be too long now. Hey. Emily and I are gonna take the stairwell. Maybe we can get down to the lobby.
Okay. You know what? Just don't make a big deal about it. I don't want the rest of these people starting to panic and making a run for the stairs.
Okay. Running out of time, aren't we?
Fire spread. We need to get these people out of here as soon as we can.
Why don't you come with us?
No, I can't. I need to stay here and help out.
Okay. All right, well, you stay safe, all right?
Yeah. Me too, big brother.
All right, okay.
All right.
It is too dangerous.
The stairwells could be the best way out.
Emily,
we're gonna try,
no.
Mom.
No,
we're
gonna try. Oh, my God. Please, will you be careful?
Yes, I promise.
Promise!
Leave this area.
Oh, well, I'm waiting for my dog, and I'm finding a young man named Jason Morgan.
You're just going to have to get going. Some respect. We're talking to Louise Phillips, one of the richest women in the country.
It's not important, Gerald. I'm waiting to find a young man named Jason Morgan and tell him that his wife is searching for him.
Kids were very brave. They never panicked. Excuse me. Emily.
James, what are you doing here?
No, it's a long story. How bad is it?
I don't know yet. We're going to need something.
This is all I could find.
Oh, okay. I don't think it's going to be enough. This could be an arterial bleed. We're going to need more than this, but... Try to make two. Don't move, sweetheart. Okay.
Remind me again why we're doing this?
The treasure is probably still in that locker
bag. Okay, yeah, the treasure, our lives, you know, and I'm coming down on the side of our lives.
We're almost there.
Could we please just forget about the treasure and
go to
the store?
Will you relax? We'll be out of here in a minute.
Yeah. Famous last words.
Yeah.
Yes! Look at that, look at that.
King me.
Maxie, heard they brought your father in. How is he?
He's still unconscious. But the doctors say that he's going to wake up soon.
And Alexander, where's he hiding now?
God, I don't know how to say this, but the fire at the hotel.
No.
I'm so sorry. Xander's dead.
Going,
I'm trying to avoid a fire and find a way out, okay? You want to stay here, be my guest.
company is better than no company.
Shut up and keep moving.
Yeah, I would like to find a little water, if that's possible.
This one's hot. We gotta keep moving.
Okay, okay.
Let's go.
Oh, God. Oh, I twisted my ankle.
Carly. Before you consider, please promise me that you're not going to tell Sonny that he's Christina's father. I don't know you a damn thing. Alexis and I have no reason to keep your secrets. And do it for Christina's sake. Okay, listen, if you're lucky, I won't make it out of here alive, and it won't matter either way. Just go.
Come on, we gotta get out of here. Wait, there's someone there.
You need to stand up. You need to walk.
Thanks for the sympathy. Okay. It's not that bad.
Good, because I sure as hell not gonna carry it.
Oh, rushing off to find Carly. Can I ask you a question?
No.
Why do you care? I thought loyalty was like a religion to you. You know, because I've been going out like buddies since you guys split.
You know what? You want to burn to death? I don't give a damn. Just stay away from me.
Okay, this should slow the bleeding a while.
You've been through worse, baby. You'll be okay.
Yes, you're gonna be just fine.
Oh, don't worry.
Look, Emily needs more medical supplies.
I know. I notified the fire captain about him's condition. He gave me a message to give to you about Courtney.
What are you talking about? She's at the penthouse with some of his kids.
No, she came here to the hotel looking for you. She rescued some women downstairs, and then she went up to get her dog.
What?
Yeah. Said Courtney was supposed to be headed for the fourth floor.
I gotta go.
It's okay. Emily's gonna be fine.
Are you okay?
Yeah, I'll be okay.
Sure. I
promise you will be too.
No, don't worry about me. Just do what Monica tells you, okay?
All right. I love you, Chase.
I love you, too.
Where are you? 10 floors of passage.
Okay, I'm gonna find a way, all right?
Hey, we worked together to save those kids. Doesn't Courtney deserve the same chance?
Nicholas.
What?
If those two can find a way down, so can you.
I'm not gonna leave Emily here.
I have done everything I can. That wound is too deep, Nicholas. I need a suture kit or she could die.
Downstairs, I need to know if Carter's been evacuated. Sonny, wait. Listen, there's still a lot of confusion about who's left in the building.
No, don't waste my time.
I need to find my wife.
No, there's still no hope of reaching the stairs, okay? Now, is there any chance of an evacuation?
Hello? I'm sorry, could you repeat that? Great, okay. Well, just, you know, don't forget us. We're up in the penthouse. Hello?
I heard that.
There aren't any sealed doors or separate ventilation. We're trapped in here, aren't we?
I didn't want you to be afraid.
Are we gonna die?
Odds are against us.
ask you something? Can you just hold me, please?
I can do better than that. May I have this dance?
I'm sorry, sir. No one but emergency personnel allowed.
It's all right. I'm a doctor. I'm here to help.
Okay, why don't you go over to my fire truck and get some bunker gear? Excuse me.
I just came from the 12th floor. There's a woman in there, Harley Corinthos. She's trapped behind a door.
I'll give them the information. Don't worry about it.
I got my nephew, Nicholas Katha, and he was at the auction.
I'll tell him, but don't worry about it. It's chaos up there. I'll get somebody to take you to the hospital.
Oh, my God. Will you please get them out of there?
I need a medical kit dropped. There's a woman up here. She's bleeding to death.
What's the matter with those damned helicopter pilots? They should be able to handle a little wind.
Daddy, it's too dangerous. They tried.
And all the while, Emily looks like she's getting weaker. Something has to be done.
We can say a prayer.
Huh? Well, all right. Emily has always been sort of a gift from heaven. Maybe God will listen now.
Dear Lord, your child Emily needs a miracle. She's been a gift to so many people and to our difficult, troubled family. Forgive us for the times we've taken it for granted and allowed ourselves to be ruled by greed. We're thankful for the lessons of love Emily has taught us. Sustain her tonight, Lord. Help her through this.
My wife's in the kitchen with her children. Mickey and Molly can't stop coughing. Can you check them for smoke inhalation?
Yes. There's my daughter's mistake. Poor Nicholas. He honestly believes that he's in love with you. It would be better for everyone if you were to bleed to death. Tragically.
You look like an idiot.
Oh, you look like a princess.
Oh, your opinion doesn't count. You're just delirious with joy for finding that stupid treasure. Now, come on, Luke. We have to move faster.
Give me a break. I'm dragging my booty as fast as I can.
Lose half of it?
Oh, perish the thought, woman.
Oh. What if we perish instead? I swear to you, Luke, that if we get killed over this heap of junk, I will never forgive you.
Before you are lucky enough to actually make it to the lobby, how do you propose we make a discreet exit, dragging and wearing stolen treasure?
Oh, you always ask the wrong question.
Somebody's coming. This is your chance to try that discreet exit.
Well, you two look to be in one piece.
Well, at least we're going the right way.
Doctor, you lost your sense of direction? Probably. Lost everything else.
Anybody?
They say it's still too windy to land a chopper on the roof, but
They may be able to get close enough to drop a medical kit.
But we don't have a lot of time, Nicholas. That tourniquet is only a temporary fix. That wound needs to be sutured as soon as possible.
Well, what if it isn't?
Then she could bleed to death.
You insipid little girl. You're not worth my grandson's life. He won't leave you to save himself. Not as long as you're in this world.
Okay, just stay in touch.
What?
There's no list of cars being evacuated.
Forget it, I'll find it.
Sonny!
Luckily, the maintenance crawl space was still open.
Oh, wait a minute.
What was that? Courtney! Courtney!
This must be the dog Courtney was looking for.
Skippy? Skippy? Oh, come here, Skippy. Come here. Yes, good boy. You scared me. Oh, my God. Oh, my God. Oh, my God.
Maybe I shouldn't write it down here.
I'm grateful. Tell me what I need to know here.
Well, there's cameras placed all over the hotel. They'll indicate which areas are passable or blocked if there's anybody down there.
These screens are dark. What does that mean?
Walls, the ceilings, they're either going or they're gone as we speak.
All right. We'll start right here.
Wait, Sonny.
What?
Help me out. Can you just have me arrest Carly for violating a restraining
order? I don't care whether you get it or not right now. Carly's my wife. I have to find her.
Stay tuned for scenes from the next General Hospital.
We promised you payoffs, and we mean now. The murder of Michael Campius, revealed. The music box killer, caught. The battle between Todd and Blair, decided. And find out who lives, who dies, and what's revealed in the fire burning on General Hospital. All My Children, One Life to Live at General Hospital. Just breathe.
On the next General Hospital, the fire rages on.
I'm exactly where I want to be.
Oh my God.
Carly's my wife. I have to find her.
In December, we help one family get the home of their dreams. And ABC Sunday, we're at it again for a whole new deserving family.
Our dad's in Iraq.
Making more dreams come true.
Whoa!
Extreme Makeover Home Edition now.
Strange for me.
What's that? Dancing?
No, being afraid and not being able to do anything about it.
We are doing something about it.
Yeah, like Nero. Fiddling while Rome burned.
Not quiet. Nero was alone.
No, I'm glad I'm not. I mean, if this is how it ends, at least I'll go out with you.
Lucky enough to actually make it to the lobby. How do you propose we make
I just
discreet exit. Dragging and wearing stolen treasure.
Oh, you always ask the wrong question.
Somebody's coming. This is your chance to try that discreet exit.
Well, you two look to be in one piece.
Well, at least we're going the right way. Doctor, you lost your sense of direction?
Probably. Lost everything else.
Were you able to get a hold of anybody?
They say it's still too windy to land a chopper on the roof, but they may be able to get close enough to drop a medical kit.
Well, we don't have a lot of time, Nicholas. That tourniquet is only a temporary fix. That wound needs to be sutured as soon as possible.
Well, what if it isn't?
Then she could bleed to death.
You insipid little girl. You're not worth my grandson's life. He won't leave you to save himself. Not as long as you're in this world.
Oh my God, it's Cassandra.
Who is that?
She's the... the hotel electrician.
You.
Grateful. Tell me what I need to know here.
Well, there's cameras placed all over the hotel. They'll indicate which areas are passable or blocked if there's anybody down there.
These screens are dark. What does that mean?
The walls, the ceilings, they're either going or they're gone as we speak.
All right. We'll start right here.
Wait, Sonny.
What?
Help me out. Can you just have me arrest Carly for violating a restraining order?
I don't care whether you get it or not right now. Carly's my wife. I have to find her.
Recognition while hiding from the police in a hotel fire. Good job raising him, huh? Really masterful.
This is no time to worry about your parenting skills, Doctor. The joint's on fire, haven't you noticed?
Oh, God.
I set him on the path that led him here. Now they're both gone. I have to do something.
Cameron, wait. Come on, just come with us, okay? Sandra wouldn't want you to die, you two.
I have to do something.
Whatever. I know that look. I've seen it in the mirror.
Well, what are we gonna do? We can't let him just walk to his death.
Well, even if he wants to? Here. Count this. I'll be right back.
Hey. Be careful.
like she was pointing an accusatory finger at you.
She warned me that the hotel's electrical system needed an upgrading immediately, and that the addition of any security for the auction could result in disaster.
And you did nothing?
What was I supposed to do? You know our financial situation as well as anyone. There was no money to revamp anything. I was going to use the proceeds from this auction to upgrade the whole system. Oh, God. I made a serious miscalculation. She was right to accuse me. Her death and any other deaths that occur will be on my hands.
All right, look, did you tell anybody else about this?
No.
Good, we're going to keep it that way.
That's the worst idea you've had yet.
Look, I had to come find him. All I could think about was Rosie.
You risked your life for a dog? You should have never been in the building.
Hey,
in the
you
first
don't get to
place.
Talk to her
Look,
that
I
way.
I knew Jason was in here somewhere. I had to come and find you in case you needed me.
You know that's crazy,
yeah,
don't
well,
you?
Well, maybe, but you would do the same for me.
Oh, this is all very touching, but we need to get out of here.
Okay, look, we're going to try the west stairwell, and then we're going to head for the roof.
But come we're on. Closer to the lobby.
Look, a rescue is being organized for the roof.
It's too far.
We don't know what's underneath us. If we hit a dead end, it's over, okay? I'm going to check the stairwell. If it's clear, we're going.
Your choice, which way?
Courtney, I'm fine. I'm gonna take another way. Just go!
Which way?
Courtney, go!
Up.
Let's go. Let's go!
I need to apologize to you.
Why? Do you think me complaining?
I'm not talking about sleeping with you. It's never been a problem for us. I'm more about missed opportunities, you know? Making wrong decisions. Like bringing you here when we still had the chance to get out of the hotel.
Yeah, well, Jax, if this is how it ends, I'm exactly where I want to be.
Jax! Open up! Open up, Jax!
Have you seen Carly?
No, I thought you'd be looking for Sam.
I did. I couldn't find her. She probably got out. Carly didn't.
Sorry, I haven't seen her. I didn't realize you were stuck on this floor as
okay.
well.
Listen, it doesn't matter. The last explosion cleared the stairwell down to the street. You got a window of about a few seconds to get out of here, so you got to get out now.
Yeah, I can help you look for Carly.
No, get out! Get out!
Jax, what the hell is the matter with you? How could you let Sonny just go off like that?
All right, keep moving. Watch your step. Stay focused. Don't think about where we are, where we're going. Just keep moving. Hand on each other's shoulder. There you go. Hand on each other's shoulder.
I'm okay. Just keep.
Good.
Look, they're trying to contain it, but they can't. We have evacuees up in the Versailles room.
I just spoke to the coroner's office. Like the body we found in the basement wasn't Xander Smith.
What are you talking about? Who was it?
There's no ID yet, all right? Xander could still be alive. So either he escaped or he's still somewhere in the building.
Don't!
Let me get this straight. You're mad at me because I didn't invite Sonny in?
No, the building is on fire, Jack. Sonny's gonna get himself killed out there.
Well, he was looking for his wife in case you missed that part when you were hiding from him. You know, it seems to me if you were so anxious to stop Sonny, you could have made your presence known and talked to him yourself. But that would mean he would know what happened between us, and I guess you don't want that.
No, Jax, what I want is to know if he is okay. Did he look hurt? Was he injured?
You know, Sonny will probably survive Armageddon. But don't take my word for it. Obviously, you're not where you want to be after all.
Jax.
No, really, if you want to run after Sonny while he runs after his wife, go ahead.
Surprised to see you, Brian. I didn't think you'd make it this far.
I don't doubt it. Especially since you sent Jason to kill me.
Maybe I should take you out myself.
Dr. Quack?
Thought you went the other way.
Well, I did, but I thought I'd give you one more chance to change your mind and come on out with me and Sky.
No. You ever think about choice, Luke? Like this fire, for example? The reasons why people wound up at this hotel on this particular night. A business trip, an affair, an auction. It all boils down to choice, doesn't it?
Look, waxing philosophical, I'm down with that. But let's ponder the vagaries of the universe over a couple of stiff drinks on me. What do you say?
Choices, Luke. Ones we make for ourselves. Ones we make for our kids.
Cameron, we've all got our ledges to stand on. You've pulled me in off a couple. Let me return the favor.
Hey, what are you doing here?
I saw you on the hotel monitor and I thought I'd come looking for you.
Watch out!
Monica, what?
She's alive, Nicholas. She's just in shock from loss of blood.
The tourniquet must have slipped off. I shouldn't have left her out here by herself.
You had to get me what I needed to stitch her up. Let's just pray it's not too late.
We have to admit that the family knew that the wiring wasn't up to code. Coming forward could generate goodwill, minimizing the threat of a lawsuit that could end up costing 10 times more than that treasure's worth.
And leave the door open for every litigious fool in Port Charles. And need I remind you? The treasure was stolen. It's gone. Not a factor.
I agree with Justice. I took the risk. I take the responsibility.
Daddy, you're not thinking clearly. There is less left of ELQ than there is at this hotel. If you go public, the family is destroyed.
What about the people who died here tonight? Or those who were so badly burned they wish they were dead? They don't matter stacked up against the almighty Quartermains?
Those almighty Quartermains happen to be your family, or so everyone reminds me ad nauseam. If we don't stick together on this, the whole lot of us might as well jump down an elevator shaft together.
Corinthos better be in here, so I can strangle him for ditching me.
Made it.
So you're thrilled. Can I ask you something?
You're giving me a choice.
Are you playing crossing guards to these ridiculous teenagers when Carly's alone somewhere in this hellhole?
Carly!
Thank you.
this office. Come on.
Oh.
That's no good. Get something to pry it up and we'll drag him out. We're gonna get you out of here.
You owe me.
I know. So stick around and prove to me that payback's a bitch.
Well, that'll have to wait for whatever comes next. But I'll hold you to it.
Well, listen, you know, just between you and me, maybe I'm wrong, but I don't think you're really a quack. In fact, you may have actually helped me a couple of times.
Your secret's safe with me. Do something for me.
What?
Take care of my... the way I never took care of my boys. Love that little girl within an inch of her life. If you don't, the regrets are profound.
Well, that's easier said than done, Doc. You're gonna have to hang around and enforce compliance.
Look, we both know that's not gonna happen. I know what dying is. Hell, I should. I've been dying inside for years. Well, that's strange. All of a sudden, doesn't hurt as much anymore.
Stairwell's cut off again. But if you still want to leave for whatever reason...
Jax, I am not denying that I care for Sonny. He was there for me when you weren't. Not that I didn't give you a reason not to be.
Right.
Listen to me, I would rather be here with you. Don't you understand that?
If you're determined to shoot me, go ahead.
Stop
right
it, Sonny. Don't do this.
Why, Courtney? Does he think he's protecting you by saying you didn't shoot him? He's a cop! He's working with Rick to take Jason and me down, and he's gonna do the same to you. He's using you! And he's gonna keep on doing it if you allow him to.
Oh, just like you're using guns and violence to solve all your problems? Brian came up here with Jason to help find me, Sonny.
You know what? He knew you would do exactly what you're doing now.
Look, I'm out of here. Do what you need to do.
Don't move. All right. I'm gonna let you go. Because I don't want blood on my hands and I don't want my sister to have to lie for me. Go.
Just keep her safe.
Brian.
Let's go.
You know, just when things can't get any worse, they do. Sonny, I mean, either Jason's sending you off to kill Alcazar or be killed by him, or you're sending Jason off to kill or be killed by Brian. I can't do this, Sonny. I am done with all of you.
You better step up, Lorenzo. You don't want Sonny finding Carly before you do. Coming out the big hero again. Of course, he could die and you'd get the whole package, the wife, kids, kingdom.
Sonny and I already collided out there, and much to your chagrin, we traded favors, and we're both still alive because of it.
Oh, how sweet. Y'all kissed and made up.
Hardly. Once this nightmare's over, all bets are off.
Of course, Carly could die. Then there'd be nothing to bet on.
How is she?
Oh, well, I stitched up the wound and the bleeding has stopped. Just keep our fingers crossed. Listen, Edward, I've got to go check on those kids. Will you take over for me for a few minutes?
What?
You'll be fine. Just hold this above her arm. You'll be fine.
All right. Oh, dear God.
Please don't take Emily as punishment for my negligence. You spare this life, and I will do everything I can to make up for all the damage that I've caused.
I've seen you looking better.
Yeah, well, you've seen me at my best. Naked, looking down at you with you begging for more. Unless you've erased that image from your mind.
If only I could.
Why are you still hanging around here, Justice? I'll bet now you wish you'd left town when you had the chance.
Excuse me. Will you please help me? I'm trying to keep my uncle from going after Carly.
Sure. I'll help you. I'll give you a piece of advice. Carly and Alcazar are two objects you don't want to get in between. That's it? Yeah, that's it. Beat it.
Lorenzo, don't go back out there.
I have to say, Carly's in trouble. I am not going to lose her.
No! Uncle Lorenzo!
It's okay. Hold on.
What happened?
I found you by the stairwell door.
The elevator. Alexis and I, we were trapped in the elevator. And then we... Jason, there's something you need to know.
Saved my life and didn't even think about it.
Oh, he thought about it. Just get under the speed.
Sorry he's dead, but I'm glad you're alive.
I got you.
Hey, listen, you said that you saw me?
Yeah, on a monitor in the security room.
Where was I? What was I doing?
It was just a couple of seconds before the fire shorted the monitor out.
Oh.
Why? Did I miss something?
No, I was just trying to get Sky out. That's when we ran into Cameron. On a mission. Mission accomplished.
All right. We have to get Cameron out of here.
Yeah, now listen, you gotta get him out. I'll get you started, and then I've gotta go back and pick up Sky. She's waiting for me.
She's important to you.
Yeah. She is important. Yeah.
Okay. So let's see if you can get that up. And...
Jason, you won't believe this.
So it's okay.
Alexis,
it's okay, Carly. I already know what happened.
How?
I found her ID in a burnt wallet, and her shoes were in the rubble right by the stairwell. And Alexis is probably underneath it.
Alexis, she's dead. What's going to happen to Christina?
I don't know. She'll go with her father, I guess.
Right, yeah, Ned. Ned'll take care of her. He'll give her a good
Are you okay? Are you strong
home.
Enough? Because we need to get out of here.
Let's go. I'm right behind you. Be careful. I guess we're not going anywhere.
You're a smart woman. Courtney, I don't know why you don't get it. You are my sister. That means you're part of me and the life that I lead. Whether you like it or not, that's a given. And you bought yourself a bigger role when you got together with Jason. Against my wishes. Right? Now you got a problem with it. I knew you would.
I shot somebody, Sonny. Call me crazy. Yeah, I have a problem with that.
You opened the door to Brian the minute you made yourself vulnerable to him.
You don't understand, do you? This life that you live and you force everyone around you to live in is not normal. Okay, regular people, they know that it is wrong to shoot someone in cold blood.
Brian had a gun on Jason. He was prepared to shoot.
You reacted in defense of your husband. That's allowed. End of story.
If he had died, Sonny, it would have been murder.
Well, too bad you didn't take it all the way.
What?
It'd have been a lot easier if Brian had died that night. Because now you've given him the ammunition to take us all down.
That's him. That's my baby. Oh, Skippy, Mama loves you. I'm so glad to see you. Oh,
hey, I got an ID on the body in the utility closet. Brace yourself. Scott Baldwin.
What? Wait a minute. What would Scott Baldwin be doing in the basement of the hotel?
I don't know. Maybe somebody put him there.
What? What are you talking
about? Come on, Rick. Kelly? We both know that Baldwin's as dirty as they come. I mean, he made side deals and enemies left and right. I had him under a microscope.
Really?
Yeah, the word out was they were getting ready to bust him.
You know what? He wasn't the only one under investigation, Capelli. You better pray that IA doesn't have you under their microscope.
Hey, look, I'm an honest cop. Right. As squeaky clean as your flunky, Brian Beck.
That the body in the utility room was in Sander. Yeah, that means he could still be in the building. Is anybody looking
Maxie,
for him?
Maxie, we're doing everything we can to evacuate everybody out of the hotel as quickly as we can, including your sister, all right?
Georgie.
Yeah, listen, she was on a list of the hotel guests. As far as we know, she's still trapped inside the hotel.
No. Sage, go get some hot water. Tom, find a tablecloth and cut it into bandages.
Done.
He could have passed out from the smoke inhalation, but he's got a really, really bad cut here that needs some cleaning and bandaging.
I cannot believe how calm you are right now.
It's a total act. I want to scream my head off, but I'm forcing myself to forget about what's happening by focusing.
Does that forgetting thing include telling me that you love me?
I didn't know if we were going to make it out of there. I still don't.
So what does that mean? Is it was a lie?
No. But it doesn't really change anything, does it? Hey, Belle. Thank you. Sage, hand me the bandages.
She's amazing. I mean, what kind of moron would let a girl like that get away?
I'm warning you. You don't want anything to do with this family. You stay out of family decisions.
We're in the midst of a major tragedy. And the family's at fault. This is far bigger than your need to feel in control.
Then let me put it another way. Butt out.
Any change?
No, she hasn't moved.
I tried to get a private helicopter to land, but no one will fly until the wind dies down.
Nicholas, can I speak with you for a second?
Yeah.
Something is bothering me about the way that tourniquet fell off.
What do you mean?
Well, I think it was done deliberately.
See that Emily has regained consciousness, you must be so relieved. You don't give a hoot about that girl. Oh, she's just one of many victims of this horrific night. And even more of a tragedy when you realize that the fire could have been avoided. What are you getting at? I believe it's called gross negligence. It's very popular in lawsuits these days. Hold on, Daddy. Let me handle this. How much? I want the treasure. We don't have the treasure. It was stolen, remember? Oh, I think it might resurface. It usually does, give or take a bobble or two. And when the treasure does surface, it's mine. Or I will tell the world that your family allowed this nightmare of death and destruction.
Sky! 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 What happened? What happened? Hey! Hey, come on, wake up! Wake up! Wake up! Sky!
Is there any word on Carly or Nicholas?
No, no. There's a lot of people trapped up in the Versailles room need to be evacuated.
Hey, someone's coming out! Bring him through here. Get it over here.
We got some help over here!
You won't need it.
Oh, God, no!
Any sign of Sander?
No. I don't see how he could have survived.
We'd end up here. When we first started, we didn't even know each other's names.
We didn't need names.
Yeah, you were my boy on the side. Nice and simple. Maybe that's where I kept going wrong. I just didn't keep it simple. Jason, there were so many things I wanted to do. I wanted to see those northern lights that you were so crazy about, and God, I wanted to go to Rio for Carnival. I wanted to see the boys grow. It's not gonna happen,
just
is it? It's
not,
there's
just
nowhere
go.
Else to go. There's a strange kind of logic in this, though. That we'd end up here together. You were always my rock. My emergency brakes, you know that you are my best friend. Do you ever think that we could have been more?
Yeah.
Was there a possibility?
I can't speak for you.
I'm not asking you to. You're dodging the question. Come on. I just need to know, did you ever feel? Did you ever feel more for me?
Yes, I did.
Me too. Why didn't we ever pursue it?
There's always something in the way.
Now there's nothing in the way. Jason, except imminent death.
Jason. Kiss me goodbye.
Can't find your way out of here alone.
Stop
what
it!
Doing?
Stop it! Sonny, I am so sick of you bossing me around and everything being on your terms and living by your code. I am out of it, okay? I'm done. I am not the sister that you want me to be, all right?
No! Move!
Stay tuned for scenes from the Next General Hospital.
On the Next General Hospital, the fire rages on.
We gotta get out of here.
Yeah. There's no way you're going up there.
Charlie. I have to find her.
I'm not ready to die.
Neither am I.
Sonny.
Panic now, we all die!
In December, we help one family get the home of their dreams. And ABC Sunday, we're at it again for a whole new deserving family.
Our dad's in Iraq.
Making more dreams come true.
Whoa!
Extreme Makeover Home Edition, now every week, premiering ABC Sunday, 8, 7 Central.
Give me the treasure, or I will tell everyone that you are responsible for this. What kind of smoke have you been inhaling? The treasure is gone. It's gone, and we are all gonna die anyway.
If we survive this, you are gonna pay dearly for putting my grandson's life in jeopardy.
You all right? Are you okay?
All things considering, pretty good. I'll stop worrying.
I'll stop worrying when you're on the first helicopter out of here.
Somebody hit you?
Yeah. Yeah, from behind. Oh, God. Hey, wait. What about, how's Cameron?
He didn't make it.
He's dead?
Yeah, and we're going to be too if we don't get out of here. Come on, these stairs lead to the roof. Oh, let's go. No, we're going to get out.
No. Whoever took their treasure couldn't go far. I'm going to go find him right now.
What are you talking about treasure? I'm the greedy one, remember?
Hey, if I can save that treasure, I can save the Quartermains.
Quartermains? Listen, if you find that treasure, it belongs to me.
What? Split that thing 50-50.
And you're gonna fight about a treasure we don't have at a time like this?
Listen, that treasure happens to be worth millions. Quartermains owe me forever. I mean, can you imagine?
Can you imagine? Us with a couple of fried eggs with a little crispy sausage on the side? Come on, let's get out of here. Come on.
Yeah. All right. We're gonna try that hallway. I'm gonna look for the treasure there.
What are you, nuts?
To heaven.
Yeah.
think then we'll see each other there.
Yeah, I think, you know, you can save the one that you love. And you're gonna finally understand what your life was really about. Now everyone's happy. Even you.
You're saying I can't be happy?
I'm just saying that you make it really hard on yourself sometimes.
Well, I can't be happy in heaven. I can't be happy in heaven if my boys are missing me, and I'm not ready to die.
Neither am I. So let's find a way to live through this, okay?
Courtney, you can't find your way out of here alone.
Stop
it!
Stop it! Sonny, I am so sick of you bossing me around and everything being on your terms and living by your code. I am out of it, okay? I'm done. I am not the sister that you want me to be.
No!
Maybe we should break the window,
no,
Jason.
No, the fire is right outside this corridor. The fresh air will pull it right in.
So what do? We sit here and we just wait?
We're gonna give the fire a chance to burn through. That's what we're gonna
do. What do you mean? We wait for the fire to just, what, pass through the corridor and just hope that it doesn't hit this room? What are the chances of that, Jason?
Not great, but it's better than us trying to run through the flames.
Well, you could do it.
What?
You could do it. Come on, Jason, you have your jacket, you've got your leather boots. You are stronger and you are faster than
you should go. I'm not leaving here without you.
Jason, you said you weren't ready to die.
You said it first.
You would be safe if you had not come to get me.
No, I would be looking for Courtney.
Yeah, but you would not be trapped in this stupid room waiting for a fire to pass on you.
Shut up!
I hate you, Jason. I hate you. I hate the way you never listen to me.
Carly,
I hate this. If you
Carly, shut
this,
up.
You can get out of
we're
here.
We're getting out of here. Together.
Oh, God. I felt like the ceiling was just going to fall down right on top of us.
Okay. Come here. Just stand right there, okay? Okay, you can hold my hand. Cooler. Stay on. Okay, look. The explosion. We cleared the hallway. We're getting out of here.
Okay.
Just be careful, okay? Okay. Fire captain
has assured me that we will all be evacuated by helicopter as soon as the wind dies down. So please, in the meantime, just try and stay calm. And if you're inclined, pray that the wind stops.
Isn't he magnificent?
Are you sure he's related to you?
If my grandson dies because of your negligence, you're toast.
During the evacuation, I don't want you anywhere near Emily.
Well, she does seem very frail.
How did that tourniquet come loose?
Oh, darling, now please don't make an issue of that. Monica is distressed enough. I mean, she must feel terrible having improperly tied her daughter's...
If I find out that you had anything to do with it, you will wish that you had died in this fire.
That kid's crazy about you, isn't he?
Daddy? Daddy?
What are you up to?
I need to take some responsibility.
For what?
You know damn well for what took place here tonight. The fires, the explosions, the injuries, the deaths that have occurred. They're all a direct result of my negligence. And I will take the responsibility.
Stifle the noble impulses, Daddy. If you make a public confession, you will bankrupt ELQ and drive our family straight to the poorhouse.
I don't see any treasure, do you?
Come
on. We gotta get out of here.
Yeah, I think you're right.
This is okay. After you, Blaze.
What the? Well, don't call me that. But there's no way that I'm going in there first.
You
no
try
way.
To be a gentleman and see what happens. Come on.
All right. So what now?
This could work.
Oh, my God. Oh, my God. We're gonna die in here, aren't we?
It's possible.
Oh, God, I can't believe. Why did you let me search this floor? Why didn't you drag me upstairs? I don't even want that stupid treasure.
You know, you're cute when you panic.
Oh, I'm not panicking. I'm having a perfectly normal reaction to being stuck in a burning building with the treasure hunting lunatic.
No, see, this is panic. It's very cute.
Oh, you better get us out of here, okay? Because I have no intention of dying in a broom closet, especially with you.
Wait a minute. This is better.
What?
Look.
You find the treasure?
There's a whole bunch of them.
Oh, my God. I don't believe it. Well, grab as many as you can. Let's get out of here.
I like your style, Blaze.
Everything for me, everything. And I don't even know if I thanked him.
Susan, we have to move to the
sure. Cameron, I'm sorry.
Where is Georgie? When are they gonna get her out?
Just try and calm down. Got some water. Come on, let's get you some water.
Honey, they're reporters.
Yeah. Wish me luck.
We'll be fine.
Mr. Lansing, how did the fire start? The investigation is still pending.
Is D.A. Baldwin really dead?
Early autopsy reports on a body found in the basement of the hotel indicate... Yes, indeed, it was Scott.
Hey, I'm glad you made it out safe.
The fire's gotten worse since then.
Do you really think Xander's dead?
Probably.
Unless he's wandering around loose up there.
Only a couple more floors.
Hey, can you take her upstairs?
Well, you're coming with us.
No, here, put this up.
What, are you crazy?
Just put the jacket on. It's the closest thing.
Okay, what about you?
I'm going to find Courtney.
Oh, well, then I'm coming with you.
No, Carly, Michael, and Morgan need you. You're going to follow him up to the Versailles room. You're getting on the helicopter, and you're getting the hell out of here.
Jason, I'll leave you.
Please, don't argue. Just do what I asked for once. Taking care of her.
Careful. You know, I've always liked this view. Even now. The wind blowing the smoke away and... God, the fire trucks are so far beneath us, they look like toys. When I was a kid, Cody gave me this truck. It was the kind that you can sit in, and it had this little bell that clanged, and it made so much noise. Somebody never told me to stop. I love that truck. And I love the fact that he had given it to me. Would you just listen to me? I'm going on and on. You think of the dumbest things when you're waiting to die.
Obvious solution.
What's that?
You don't think.
The death of Scott Baldwin is a terrible tragedy.
Weren't you after his job?
Next question.
Was the hotel wiring below code?
I can't comment on that.
Do you suspect it was arson?
Well, anything could have happened. As I said, the investigation is pending.
Is Xander Smith the suspect?
Well, he hasn't been ruled out. And just to be clear, early confirmations of his death have not been confirmed, so he's still armed and dangerous.
Is he in the building?
I don't know. At least it's possible, yes. It's the last place he was seen.
Did Xander Smith kill the DA?
I can't comment on that. As I said, the investigation is still pending. When we get more information, we will let you know. Thank you very much.
Base to evac. Do you copy?
Base to evac.
That's a copy.
Hey, give me Nicholas Cassadine.
I'm right here.
Hey, big brother. How the winds up there?
It's still pretty bad.
All right, listen to me. Just try to keep everybody calm up there. We're gonna land those choppers the minute we know it's safe.
Sooner would be better.
Is Georgie Jones up there?
Yeah, she's right here.
All right, I'll let Max know. How's Emily doing?
Monica sutured her cut, but...
She's lost a lot of blood, lucky.
There any other injuries?
Just smoke inhalation. Well, there's one woman, the hotel electrician, I think. She's dead.
Well, we're coming to get you out of there. You don't worry, all right?
You know where to find us.
What are the odds of us getting on that chopper?
Well, let's see. After poor little Emily, Prince Nicholas, and the ridiculous teenagers, I'd say we might as well take a swan dive down an elevator shaft.
You call it like it is. That's what I like about you.
And you never pay a compliment without wanting something. So what is it?
The truth.
What the hell? Probably dead within the hour.
Did you ever really give a damn about me?
Uncle Lorenzo, wait. Stay there.
Carly, wait a minute. You barely made it up the stairwell.
I do not have time.
Is he okay?
You knocked him out!
I was trying to help.
Maybe you should go take a walk.
I'm gonna be on the terrace.
Let us know when the wind dies down.
Thanks, Dylan.
Isn't he magnificent?
You need a splint. Here.
You gotta hurry, okay?
All right, well, I'm trying. Okay, this needs a holder. It's no good.
Ow, don't. No, keep going. Just go.
All right.
All right. Tighten it hard.
All right.
As hard as you can. Ow! Nothing. All right. Get me up. You got enough help.
Can you walk?
Wait a minute.
Why is this happening?
You ready, Blaze?
Why do you keep calling me that?
I always wanted to know a woman named Blaze.
Really? Well, now you do.
All right, baby. Get to the door. You ready?
Yeah.
Now!
Hey, what are you doing?
All right, I'll check in as soon as I touch down on the roof.
You got it.
There's no way you're going up there.
You'd think they'd already have helicopters in the air circling, waiting for a chance to land.
I'm sure they're doing whatever is safest.
Really? For them or us?
Why don't you go out on the terrace with your son?
Because it's freezing!
Oh, God, it's official. You are absolutely devoid of parental instincts.
You! I learned from the best!
Can we fight about this when we get home?
Absolutely.
Yes, thank you.
You know I gave a damn. That was the whole problem. I was in love with someone else. You were supposed to keep him out of prison. You didn't. He died. Because of you.
I didn't kill him, Faith.
You tanked the case.
I'm not sure I did.
You wanted me.
I'm sure of that. Just like I'm sure you wanted me.
It was a long time ago. I have gone on and, you have too, right? Whatever.
Oh, Carly.
It's all right.
I have to find her.
No, you're not strong enough.
I guess I took in a lot of smoke before I found you. Oh, thank God. I was coming for you.
You didn't have to. A firefighter got me. He was... He's gone.
Oh, God, Mr. Alcazar,
it's me.
Yeah.
How's he doing?
His girlfriend just got here. He's kind of focused on her at the moment.
Good. Good, good, good.
Look, about Georgie.
She loves you. I know. Look, that makes you incredibly lucky, okay? So just be smart. Don't be stupid like me and mess it up.
Well, the thing is, Georgie's unlike any girl I've
Tom,
ever met.
Tom, I'm telling you, okay? If you miss out on Georgie, it's like missing out on the Super Bowl and Christmas and the 4th of July all rolled into one, okay?
Did you ever tell her that?
No.
People think I'm stupid.
Dylan.
Hey, what's going on? Everything okay?
Everything's fine. I wanted to make sure you're okay.
Wait. Do you feel that? It feels like the wind is dying down. Maybe we can get a helicopter and get ourselves out of here.
Is he alive?
No.
Jax, we're running out of time.
Maybe not. I think this fireman may have given us a way out.
I think Carly's wearing Jason's jacket. Maybe she knows where he is.
Well, if that's true, she doesn't seem too worried about him.
Oh, Jason's a survivor. He'll be all right. He's probably already out of the hotel.
Thank God you're safe.
You're not okay. What happened?
I'm fine. You tell me what happened.
I was caught in the elevator with Alexis. We finally got out. I made it to a stairwell.
There was an explosion. And I got trapped. And then Jason came and he cut me, he always does. And he got me somewhere safe, and then he went straight back into the fire to get Courtney. Does anyone know when they're gonna start taking us down?
Sage might. I've been in and out of consciousness.
But Lorenzo, why didn't you say anything to me?
Oh, poor me, I was in a fire.
This is not funny. Don't make jokes. Are you all right?
As soon as you walked in the door, everything was just fine.
Guys, the wind is dying down. Tell them to send the chopper.
Lucky, pick up. Send the chopper.
Has anyone seen Sonny?
He's in the building somewhere.
He has to make it out safe.
To start a family. You can't risk your life on the roof of that building.
Look, I have no choice.
Look, honey, listen. You're compensating because you're on the only elevator that got through.
No, that's
you
not fair.
You didn't push anybody out of the way. You got on the elevator because they told you to.
Sweet,
no, please,
sweetheart,
you can't go.
I have to supervise the evacuation, all right? It's the only way to avoid it.
There are plenty of firefighters.
Yes, and they're needed elsewhere. Like it or not, I am the ranking official here. If I can help those people get down here safely, then I have to try.
Lucky, can you hear me?
Go ahead. Did you hear me? Send the chopper.
It's on its way.
Oh. Rick, it's time to go.
Wait. Just come back, okay? That's all I ask. Just come back.
Rick.
Not that bad, it's all right.
You're such a tough guy.
Real ones, you yell and scream. I learned a long time ago it doesn't work.
Yeah. No, it's not easy being your sister.
Yeah, you mentioned that about 800 times already.
Well, you were right about Jason and me.
Not necessarily, you know.
Ow! Oh, sorry.
You guys, you know, you love him, he loves you. That's a lot.
I feel everything changed the second I shot Brian. Did you ever have a second like that? You crossed the line and you knew that your life was going to be different.
Yeah, I beat up on my stepfather for years and years of him beating on my mother and me. I finally got the courage to fight back. I took that bastard down, I threw him out. And guess what my mother says? I thought she was going to thank me. She says, hey, Michael, leave. I don't want you in deep fight anymore.
How old are you?
16. So the next day, I stole a car from a guy named Scully. I thought he was going to kill me because he caught me. But he gave me a job instead.
In the mob?
He made the organization. I took any job they gave me, you know. I moved up the ranks, gave me respect, money. And after Scully took care of Deke for me, there was no way out.
What about now?
I like this life. But my kids are gonna have a better choice. They're not gonna be raised by some drug dealer and his mistress.
You love Carly, Sonny.
Come on, let's get out of here.
Right.
Okay, wait, it's not working.
Do you ever listen to anybody?
Yeah, I listen. I just don't do what people want me to do sometimes, you know, because I can't. Sorry, I caused you more pain than happiness.
So that's how I get an apology out of you. Trap you in a burning building and wreck your knee.
Well, you know I love you.
I love you, too.
Yeah, if I'd have done that, we'd both be in the crispy bucket by now, and you know it.
That is not funny. Oh, my God.
Damn.
Oh, my God. Wait. Look.
I think he's been shot.
Astute observation, Blaze.
Well, I mean, he has been suffocated, all right. Well,
here, help me get
him
up. Help me get him up.
But hey, he's a cop. You hate cops.
Yeah, well, my kid's a cop. In a similar situation, some spud comes along and finds him.
Yeah, I guess
I hope to hell he helps.
That makes sense. Come on. Oh, God, it's heavy.
I don't mind telling you, I'd a hell of a lot rather be hauling out the treasure.
Oh, my. Insane.
Not as insane as sitting around waiting to die. At least this way we have a fighting chance.
Yeah, Jack is about 1 in 10 million.
Aren't you the one who said you hated being afraid and not being able to do anything about it?
Can you just not quote me back to myself right now, please, and tell me what the plan is?
Okay. This floor is almost fully engulfed with flames. I'm going to rappel down the outside of the building, re-enter a couple floors down, and hopefully we'll find our way to the stairwell all the way down to the street. Only question is, do you want to jump on my back, or do you want to do this on your own?
No, you go and I'll just follow, okay?
Have you got any climbing experience?
No, don't worry about me, please. I'm not afraid of heights.
Okay. Whatever you do, do not look down, okay?
What is keeping that fool helicopter?
We'll hear it in a minute, Edward.
The wind could pick back up at any minute.
Just stay calm, will you?
Fine.
Okay, how soon till we evacuate?
Should be any time now.
All right, good.
Where were you when you realized there was the fire?
In a stairwell fighting with Sonny.
No, I thought it was the
Don't last worry, night. When I left Sonny, he was fine. I saved his life.
You did?
Yeah, after he saved mine, now we're even. Free to despise each other forever and ever.
Yeah, you two are both insane.
It's quite possible. We're also equally good at taking care of ourselves. I made it this far. I'm sure Sonny will, too.
What's taking them so long?
The helicopter will get here.
You don't know that.
Yes, I do. It's like when something special comes along in your life and you just need to grab hold and hang on. Because if you don't, it's like missing the Super Bowl, Christmas, and 4th of July just wrapped up in one.
Well, at least this is a free bar.
You are already in heaven.
Heard that from you before.
It seemed that way.
That first night. Saying you'd forgotten to get a signature.
I had to get you up to my office somehow.
Well, you lacked creativity.
I'm creative in other ways.
Yes, you were. Especially on that desk.
It was a good night.
Yeah. It was a good night.
Oh my God! Okay, come on, let's try this again.
Get out of the way!
Everybody,
important.
Why are you not letting this through?
Let's try to move up to the front.
What about Sonny and Jason and Courtney?
Merle and Miss Crafton's out. We'll have the bar all to ourselves.
Something to look forward to.
If we mob the helicopter, it won't be able to lift off. Think.
Oh.
All right, that's the emergency generator.
How soon can they get us out of here?
Just a few minutes, all right? Everybody, please try to remain calm. We'll get you out as quickly as we possibly can.
Come.
How the hell did you get here?
I came through the building. I went stairwell to stairwell.
Yeah, but why? There's plenty of rescue workers here.
Because I want to help, the same as you.
Here, I got him. Please, back. Is he dead?
I don't think so. Did Lucky make it out?
Yeah, he got dead.
This man's been shot. He needs to get to a hospital.
How many seats do you have?
7. The teenagers and the 2 kids go first. That leaves 1 seat.
The helicopter landed safely on the roof.
I was hoping to see some of my family members coming down the stairs.
It's the safest way to evacuate.
Do you know how long that'll take? I mean, besides, you made it down the stairs.
Barely, and there were explosions since then. If the stairways aren't already blocked, they've got to be filled with smoke, and the helicopter is the safest way for people like your grandfather to get off the building.
I was supposed to be at that auction.
I was there, and I left before the fire was reported, so if you're going to make yourself feel guilty about it, then I suppose I should join you.
It's not guilt. It's frustration. I should have been paying closer attention to my family. The Quartermains own this hotel. This whole disaster is our responsibility.
Excuse me, wait a minute, please. Excuse me, did you just come out of the building? Have you seen Rick Lansing?
Hey, where are you going? Get back here, that's an order!
Ryan, did you see who shot you?
They're okay. That's who shot me.
Stay tuned for scenes from the next General Hospital.
On the next General Hospital, the fire rages on.
You're under arrest.
Rick! This is murder!
Far enough.
It's my fault. If I hadn't lost my temper, a lot of things would be different.
There's no way they could have survived this fall. Sonny and Carly are dead.
In December, we help one family get the home of their dreams. And ABC Sunday, we're at it again for a whole new deserving family.
Our dad's in Iraq.
Making more dreams come true.
Whoa!
Extreme.